is Jackie Bolhuis from Klompen Stampers. I have a super quick and easy fun fold card for you today. You know me, it's all about quick and easy. And every once in a while I'll throw in a fun fold, but they're always quick and easy as well. I think you're really gonna like this one. So before I flip the camera down, just a quick reminder, make sure you subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And there's that little bell right down there that you can click on. And when you do that, then you're always notified when I upload a new video. So, and if you're looking for a Stampin' Up demonstrator or you need a Stampin' Up catalog, make sure you get a hold of me. I would love to be your demonstrator and help you with all your stamping needs. But today, we're all about a quick and easy fun fold. So let me go ahead, flip the camera down, show you the card, and show you how easy it is to make. So hold on one sec. This is the card we're making today. And like I said, it's a fun fold. And fun fold really just means it's something different than a half sheet of cardstock folded in half for a normal card, as we like to call them. So this one, when we open up like so, you can see there's a little pocket inside. And then this pulls out, and that's where my greeting is. So that's why we call it a fun fold. It's not just a fold in half card with the message on the inside. Super easy to make. And we're gonna do some fun stamping using the Butterfly Gala stamp set. Now this comes with a coordinating punch, and I'm going to use that too. And just up until June 3rd, you can purchase this together and save 10% on it because it is a bundle. It will be in the new catalog, so if you don't get it, you know, by then it's fine, but it won't be bundled, so you won't get to save that 10% on it. Great stamp set, great verses, lots of fun with it, and I've got some great tips that I'm going to show you for using this as we get going here. So let's go ahead and start. Now you'll notice this card here I made with the color Mint Macaron. It's basically monochromatic, which simply means we're really using just one color, except I did add the soft suede on that. So I'm gonna do the same thing on this one, but we're using Highland Heather. Now, what I really wanted to highlight here and remind you of is this beautiful designer series paper that it comes in a pack that has for each color group, I guess. I can't even figure out how to explain it to you guys. So there's the regals, there's the brights, there's the subtles, and then there's the neutrals and each of the in colors. Now these papers are retiring. So right now they're on while supplies last. So when they're gone, they're gone. But if you like Stampin' Up! Colors, these papers are awesome because they coordinate so nicely with our colors. So grab those packs when they're gone. Each pack has quite a few sheets of each color, and there's two different designs, actually four because they're double-sided, but so you can get the polka dots with the stripes, or this one has polka dots and stripes also, but it's got the white in there with it. So like I said, it comes in the color group, so you get all the colors within the color group in each pack. So enough of that. Like I said, it's monochromatic, so since I'm using Highland Heather Designer Series paper, we're gonna use Highland Heather paper or cardstock for our card base. 8.5 by 5.5 are normal measurements for a card, but rather than folding it in half, I've already scored it at 2.5 and 6.5. Now don't worry about all of these measurements because I'll have a link in the description that'll take you over to the post that'll give you all the details. I'll list all of the supplies, all the measurements, and show you more pictures of the card to make it super easy for you. So once again, we're scored at 2.5, so we're gonna fold that up. I like to use my bone folder to get just a really nice crisp fold in there. And then 6.5, that's the top one. We'll use that bone folder again. So our card is going to open up like so. Then I already pre-cut a couple pieces of the designer series paper. So our first one is going to go on our larger flap, which is the top here. And this is going to be 5.25 by 2.25. Now, you know me and my liquid adhesive, my favorite adhesive that I love to use. The trick is number one to get it coming out. There we go. And just rub it on there. Don't get too much. You don't want it gushing. And to me, as long as I have my tip actually rubbing on there so you can hear it with very, very little pressure, you're not going to get too much. One of the reasons I like this is when I adhere it down, I can slide it around a little bit to get it placed exactly where I want it. And we'll go ahead and rub that. And then now on the other one, we've got 5.25 by 1.75. Oops, almost on the wrong side. This time I want the stripes showing. So we're going to put the adhesive on the polka dot side, and that's going to go right there like so. Okay, rub it down good. Now because this is gonna be a pocket card, we're gonna put just a little bit of adhesive, and again, very little, right on that edge. I think here you can probably see better. Okay, very little, and then go ahead and press that down. Just give it some good pressure. This glue dries pretty quick, so as long as you get it there so it sets. So there's the base of our card. Now let's go ahead and decorate it. So let's start with the inside piece here. So this is, let's say, 4.5 by 3.25, I believe. We are going to use all stamps from the Butterfly Gala. So the first one is Thank You Very Much, and we're gonna ink this up in Soft Suede. And we'll, oh, we almost put that upside down. That wouldn't have been so good, would it? And we're gonna just go ahead and put it up towards the top here, kind of over to the right side. I want it pretty far up to the top, so when it's in the pocket, it shows. Now, butterflies. This stamp set has several different butterflies, and when you first look at it, you'll see that the big one and the small one are together on one stamp. And that's what matches our punch. So it makes it real easy to stamp both at the same time and then punch them both. However, I don't always want to stamp them together. So a few of them, I actually cut them apart. But never fear, because if you ever want to stamp these again, and this block's too small, but I could easily just put those together on a block and it's like I never cut them. So it's a little tip there on those. And then we're going to use Highland Heather ink, because again, we're monochromatic. So we'll do a small butterfly there, and then let's do a large one down there. Now in this set, you also have the butterfly bodies. So we'll go ahead and do the large body. I just have lots of parts and pieces here. Good thing I got quite a few clear blocks, so I don't have to keep taking them on and off all the time. Then we've got the antennae as well. So there's the large one, and then we'll grab the small one, like so. Since they're photopolymer stamps, it made it really easy to line that up. So we're gonna slide that in there. Okay, there's our pocket card. Now, I've already punched out, I believe this is 2.25-inch circle. And really, whatever size circle you have, as long as it's large enough to fit your verse in that you're using. And I'm going to grab my stamp I need here. Okay, so I have the Good Things in Life Are Better With You. Once again, we're gonna stamp that up with Soft Suede, and I'm gonna try to go way over to that right edge because I want some room to add on a couple of butterflies. Then we'll take a piece of scrap Whisper White, and this is where I'm gonna stamp my butterflies together. So they're on one stamp, so I have my large and my small one, and then when I take my punch, I can go in here and I can line up, and we'll get both of those punched out at one time. Now notice that I did not stamp the antennae. I like to wait until after I've punched it and then line it up on that punch piece. And you could try it the other way. It's really kind of a personal preference, but I found it was a little bit easier for me to stamp it afterwards. And there's really no way to do the antennae on those, but that's okay. Now, we're gonna adhere this down. I like to use glue dots for these real little pieces like that. And what I'm gonna do is I can see where it is here, and I'm gonna kind of fold it on half, and then it'll fit on that body. These glue dots give it a little bit of a raised up surface. So we'll just go ahead, we'll stick that one there. And then this one, I just kind of bent them a little bit. We'll use a glue dot on that one as well. And we just want to place this one so we're not really covering up any of our words. So there is that. And then I can go ahead and grab some dimensionals, because you know I can't make a card without dimensionals. And make sure you just put them on the top, because this is going to be hanging off that top flap on our card. So we'll go ahead and stick that like so. Okay, and you can see this is why I didn't adhere these all the way up, because I want them to be able to flap around a little bit here. And then the last thing I did was we'll just add a couple of little a little bling, as we like to call it. So I have these self-adhesive, what do we call these? Sequins. And these have the flower shapes in them that I thought would be perfect. So why don't we, I have to use my piercing tool, or you can take a pick tool and pop these up. And we'll stick those on there, and that just gives a little bit of shimmer and shine. And there we go. So here's our one in Highland Heather. We'll pull that out for the inside. And then here's the one in Mint Macaron. So like I said, you could do these in any color. But don't forget that this paper is retiring. And as of the time I made the video, all colors of it were still available, all color packs. But if you'd like to get this, it's a staple. You can always use this with these coordinating colors. So as always, if you have any questions at all, make sure you go ahead and get a hold of me. I would love to help you. I'd love to send you a catalog if you need one, or answer any of your stamping or Stampin' Up questions. So until I get to stamp with you again, have a stamp happy day.